Honorable President, I wish to read some paragraphs from the English version of your address to both the House of Parliament assembled together today, and the rest of the address may be considered as read. Honorable members, this joint sitting of the Parliament, which is being held during the time of the coronavirus pandemic, has great significance. It is the beginning of the new year and a new decade. We will also be entering the 75th year of India's independence this year. All the members of Parliament present here today embody the conviction held by every Indian that the toughest of challenges will deter neither us nor India. Whenever India has remained united, it has been able to attain even seemingly unattainable goals. This solidarity and Pooja Babuji's inspiration had given us freedom from hundreds of years of colonial rule. Echoing the same spirit, Assam Kesari, Ambikagiri Roy Chowdhury, the nationalist poet, said, Om Tat Sat Bharat Mata Ek Chetanat Ek Dhyanat Ek Sadhonat Ek Avegat Ek Hoija Ek Hoija. That is, India's grandeur is the ultimate truth in one single consciousness. One thought, one devotion, one inspiration. Let us unite, let us unite. This unity and dedication of Indians have enabled country to overcome multiple adversities. Our country has faced every crisis with fortitude, be it coronavirus, floods, earthquakes, or major cyclones in several states, locust attack, or bird flu. The recent past also saw an unprecedented escalation in tension along the border. The nation stood together, battled crisis on multiple fronts, and surmounted every challenge. During this period, we will all have also witnessed unparalleled courage, endurance, discipline, and spirit of service of our countrymen. Honorable members, when we think of the preceding year, we are reminded of the twin challenges that faced us, saving the lives of the citizens and protecting the economy. Besides announcing a record economic package for reviving the economy, my government took care to ensure that no poor person went hungry. Under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, 80 crore people were provided an additional 5 kg free food grains for 8 months, per month. We have also taken care of the plight of the migrant laborers, workers, and those who are away from their homes, besides providing them with the facility of One Nation, One Ration Card. The government made free fruit grains available and organized ceramic special trains for them. During this period, India has demonstrated scientific capabilities, technical expertise, and strength of startup systems by developing a network of over 2,200 laboratories in a short span, manufacturing thousands of ventilators, PPE kits, and test kits, thereby attaining self-reliance. It is a matter of immense pride that India is conducting the world's largest vaccination program. Both the vaccination rolled out under this program are produced indigenously. By making lakhs of corona vaccine doses available to several countries, India fulfilled its obligation towards humanity in these times of difficulty. The accolades being showered on India globally for this work, along with the essence of our age-old cultural tradition of Sarve Santu Niramaya and endeavor to work for human welfare, is imparting strength to our efforts. Atmanirbhara Bharat is not just confined to manufacturing in India, but also campaign aimed at elevating the standard of living of every Indian, as well as boosting the self-confidence of the country. Our goal of an Atmanirbhara Bharat will be further strengthened by self-reliance in agriculture. With this idea, the government have for the last 6 years attempted to bring positive transformation in the seed-to-market system so that the Indian agriculture is modernized and also sees growth. In pursuance of these efforts, my government decided to implement the recommendations of the Swaminathan Commission report and increase the MSP by at least 1.5 times of the cost of production. Today, my government is not only purchasing record quantities at the MSP, but also increasing the number of procurement centers across the country. I'm happy to say that their hard work, our farmers are augmenting the efforts of the government. Today, the food grain availability in the country is at a record high. 2000